Welcome to POCUS Geek. In this video, we're going to talk about the sub-xiphoid short access. This is a great view to be able to obtain, especially in patients when you're not able to get good parasternal views. In the past, when I first did a cardiac ultrasound, I did not get this very often, kind of considered it a supplemental view. Now I do it in every patient just because I think there's so much information to obtain from it. So what you want to do when you start with to get this view, you want to get your standard sub-xiphoid view. And how you do this is put the probe in the sub-xiphoid view, and you're going to fan and angle up towards the patient's left shoulder until you get a view similar to this. And what you're going to see at the top of your screen is your liver, and the right ventricle is going to be right up next to the liver. Just inferior to that on your screen is going to be the left ventricle. This view allows us to assess the global function of the heart. It allows us to look and see if there's any surrounding free fluid or pericardial sac fluid, and also allows us to look at the chamber sizes. Several of the binary questions we have when we look at performing a cardiac ultrasound. So from this view, we want to keep the heart in view to move to our sub-xiphoid short axis view. And what we're going to do is we're going to rotate our probe marker to the 6 o'clock position or towards the umbilicus. When we do this rotation, you want to make sure that you continue to aim the probe towards the patient's left shoulder. And then you're going to fan the probe until you can see the papillary muscles, which we can see right here and right here. And what we'll notice is that the diaphragm is right here between the liver and the heart and then continues down. And sometimes you're going to see your aorta just like we do here, but not always. It just depends on what plane that's in. But this is a great view to just think of a central dot right here in the middle of the left ventricle, and we can appreciate how concentric the contractility is and how well that is functioning. So let's look at one live here. So we have a sub-xiphoid short axis here. We can see again the liver at the top of the screen. We see the heart just inferior to that, or the left ventricle. And we can see here that the contractility is really good, and that it's very concentric, that there's no wall motion abnormalities. Also, we can evaluate that there's no free fluid around the heart in this view. From here, we're going to move forward to get an IVC view. And all we have to do is start to angle the probe down. And this is going to get us perpendicular again to the skin. And then we're going to fan over towards the patient's right. This will allow us to bring into view the IVC. And we'll get a view similar to this. We want to see the IVC traveling through the liver. And if we can, we want to try to identify that hepatic vein. In this view, we can watch the mobility of the IVC. We can see if it's compressible. And what we're seeing right now is some variation with the emptying of the right heart. But then we can also see some respiratory variation. And by looking just distal to the hepatic vein right in this area, we can see how much compressibility it has with inspiration. And that variation can help us know what the CVP is, or central venous pressure. So I'm going to show you a study going through the different views. So here we see our four-chamber view of the heart. And we're just going to go through this study and see how we progress to obtain the sub-xiphoid short axis view. So what we're going to see is we're going to start to rotate the probe here. We see the mitral valve come in. Then we see those papillary muscles right in the middle. We can appreciate the contractility here. From there, we're going to swing down, and our diaphragm will move towards the left side of the screen, and then we're going to see that IVC. So once again, we have a four chamber of the heart. Here we're going to start to rotate our probe, and we'll see right in the middle screen the mitral valve till we then fan to the papillary muscles. And then again, we're going to start to angle down towards the umbilicus. We will see the aorta come into view, and then we'll fan towards the right, and here we see the IVC, and in this patient, it's very compressible. I hope you find this video useful on obtaining the sub-xiphoid short axis. Again, I think this is a great view to have in your wheelhouse as far as doing cardiac ultrasound. If you have any questions about this video or any other point of care ultrasound related questions, feel free to reach out to me at pocusgeek@gmail.com, or you can follow me on Twitter @pocusgeek. Take care.